with Scripts and Scribes. We are at Free Comic Book Day, hosted by The Comic Bug, and we are speaking with Brian Vigilato.
Hi there.
Hello.
How
thank
you, doing?
You. I'm good.
Were you in a short film last year?
I mean, I may have been.
Was it called, like, Sons of the Devil?
Something like that. I can't really remember.
I kind of remember you being in that.
Yeah. There was this guy who wrote it. He was okay. You know?
He's kind of a dick. Can I say that? No?
Okay. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Yeah.
It's kind of busy here.
It is busy here.
Yeah.
That's good though, right?
Yeah.
That means people are interested.
I'm
scared of what? All these people who want
free
you?
Stuff.
That's
not
you?
Me, but free stuff.
I mean, unless you are the free stuff.
I don't want to be the free stuff. Okay.
What are you working on right now?
Right now, I am still on Detective Comics for DC with Francis Manapul, and I am writing Injustice, which is based on the video game. Year 4 is about to start. I think the first issue or first chapter comes out in May. And I have a book called Sons of the Devil coming out from Image on May 27th. First issue drops.
So, it's very exciting.
Yeah, it is exciting.
Yeah.
So that's kind of what I got going on right now.
Okay, perfect.
How about you? And what do you have going on?
You know, life.
Life,
enjoying
yeah.
the not 100 degrees here in Culver City, because where I live, it's 100 degrees.
See, I live in Santa Monica, so...
Okay, well, we don't have to talk about that.
Jealous?
A little.
Okay.
But it's all right. I'll get over it. Okay, so can you tell me about... Because you did a Kickstarter for Sense of the Devil.
I did.
Can you give us an idea of what that process was like?
Well, I mean, it's a long process. I think the big thing is making the video and selling yourself and what the project is. And also showing people that you can deliver. I think the hard part for Kickstarter for people is everyone thinks, oh, I'll do a Kickstarter. But if you don't have any track record of being able to put out the thing that you say you can, it's really going to be hard to get money from strangers. And if you can't get money from strangers, then you need to get money from your friends and family, and if you're in comics or in writing, you know, something like that, from your fan base. But if you don't have a giant fan base, you know, you gotta be careful about how much money you ask for. I think we asked for a modest amount. We asked for, I think, $24,000, and we were able to hit it. I think it's knowing how much you can get, and then also, you know, being out there on social media and really sort of pounding the pavement, so to speak. So it was a great experience. We, you know, we were fully funded, and you know, we got to make a comic book and a short film. So,
which is amazing.
Yeah.
So congratulations.
Well, thank you.
Yes.
Yeah. And we got to cast somebody who looked just like you.
Bizarre.
To play Nerdy Girl.
Absolutely bizarre. Nerdy Girl. Why? Okay.
No.
Typecasting. Totally.
Oh, nerd.
Okay, so...
I've been doing this a lot. I don't know why. It's like I'm hoedowning.
Wait, you... Like, we'll do it opposite.
I'm gonna do it.
Okay.
Okay.
So, you... How did you get your start in comic book writing?
In comic book writing? Well, I've been coloring comic books for about 20 years, and during that time, a big love of mine is film, so I taught myself how to write screenplays. Over the course of 10 years, I started out sucking really bad, and then I just sucked less and less and less and put in my hours and improved to the point where my friend Francis Manapul, who's you know, an amazing artist and a fan favorite, he got offered the opportunity to do Flash when the New 52 started. And having never written anything by himself before, he asked if I would write it with him. So that kind of opened the door for me, and it changed how people perceived me. I went from being a colorist who has this screenplay that no one's ever going to read to being a comic writer, and so that sort of changed the whole dynamic for me. So for me, it was about, I guess, getting the skills where people would have faith in me to write, and then, you know, relationships. I mean, really, most anything involves relationships. You have to go out there, network, and meet people, and be in the right place at the right time. So I think it's, you know, being prepared and being determined and networking.
This is actually what I was going to kind of wrap up with, or, you know, suggestions and tips for how people can kind of get their start. So with that being said, networking, having the skills, I think obviously the skills, right, you know, put the work in. But networking, I feel like that's kind of an elusive topic. So,
but you know what, there's different ways to network. I knew somebody who was in like an accounting department at DC, and that's how they got their start in the writing. Like, you know, get a job working for the company that you want to be with. You know, maybe you can't get a job doing the thing you want to do, but that's how you meet the people that hopefully you can develop those relationships with. You can do it in school, you can do it in clubs. I mean, like, You have to go out there and do stuff and meet people. You can't do it in a vacuum. You can't think that I wrote something great, I'm going to hold it up to the sky, and the gods are going to come down and take it. You know, like, that doesn't happen. Doesn't matter how good you are. Well, it hasn't happened to me yet, so I'm, please, God. So, I don't know. Yeah. That's my two cents.
No, I think that's great. And I think it's also important that you brought up, you know, you actually have to have the work behind you, too. You have to be prepared. You have to...
Yeah. I mean, I think part of it is you have to be realistic about what your ability level is, you know? I mean, you can't be so precious about your work that you can't step back and say, ooh, that sucked. You know what I mean? I think one great thing about evolving as a writer is if you look back at your stuff and you hate it, then I think you've improved. And that's a good thing. Like, don't be afraid of looking back at your old stuff and saying, wow, did I write that? Like, if... When I cringe at my older stuff, it makes me kind of happy because I'm like, wow, I suck way less than I used to. So I don't know.
All right. That's fair. That's completely fair. Yeah. Thank you very much for your time.
Absolutely.
Oh, wow. We're like official.
Yeah.
Handshake and all.
I'm gone.
I'm here with Scripts and Scribes.
Hey, guys.